Make yourself at home.
Eh?
Bloody half an hour in the shower.
Oh, so?
Oh, nothing.
Anything on the news?
Oh, some clown's doing a siege up at Silver Heights. Pregnant hostage the whole damn bit.
That'll keep the coppers busy. Well,
cheers. Cheers, nothing. I'm scared witless, if you must know.
Oh, why? What's going to go wrong?
Well, that kid next door, for a start. I wouldn't trust her as far as I could throw her.
Ah, there's nothing wrong with Yvonne. Nothing that a proper pair of parents wouldn't fix. How about them, eh? Just going off for the weekend like that. Bloody criminal, I call it.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, I do. 16, she is.
Well, what do you care? She's not yours.
I like her. I might go and see how she's getting on her own.
Oh, why don't you?
You know, Val, you're turning into a real sour old woman.
You're not helping.
You're having a party.
That's right.
Want a beer? Well, you've certainly got enough.
Got some of the blokes that are whipped round at the pub.
Oh, at the pub, eh?
I don't know how many people are coming. Sort of open house.
No thanks, love. Listen, what do your parents think about all this?
They don't know. And they wouldn't care. Hey, you should come tonight. No problem. You'd be safe. We all hate the pigs.
Yeah, well, they've got a job to do, haven't they?
Huh, job. Like that poor guy they're going to blow sky high in a minute at Silver Heights.
Oh, that siege.
Mm. Hear that? What a sweet note in those big choppers.
Now, where did you learn all that?
I get around.
Listen, don't say anything about me, all right?
Where's the party?
Just started.
What's the time?
3 o'clock in the bloody morning.
Haven't you been to bed yet?
No, I'm worried, Val. Those boys over there are real mean, not the type to muck around. She's gonna get herself raped.
Probably just what she wants, little slut.
It is not. She's a 16-year-old kid that ought to be in bed alone.
At 16? Oh, come on, they're all at it.
Oh, yeah? Well, not this one. I'm going over there.
Oh, what if somebody recognises you?
Now, you get your hands off her. She's just a kid.
Who's this?
Just a friend from next door. A friend with a secret.
Shut up, you. You're drunk.
What's so surprising? This is a party.
Yeah, well, party time's over. Tell your bum friends to get lost.
Get her. Don't like your style, lady.
Oh, really? Then scrape your friends together and just get out of here.
I'm going to break your face.
Come on, Wonder Boy. You make a terrific target in those tight jeans. They'll be calling you Squeaky.
Hey, tough mama.
All right, they're going. Everybody out.
She's a lover. I thought we was getting it together.
Maybe another time, huh? Now, you better do as she says and get out.
Ah, let's get out of here. Stupid Sheila's underage. Bubsy's got to do what Mama says.
All right, you. Now get to bed. What a mess.
You checking up on me again?
Oh, I thought you were like a hand tidying up.
Really?
I want to know how you were.
Hung over for nothing.
That'll teach you.
You made a fool of me last night.
Oh, come on, Yvonne, now relax.
I'm not a child, you know.
Yes, you are. You're sweet 16 now. Why do you want to go spoiling that?
How many people have you killed?
2 on last count.
And all I was going to do was get laid. Pretty pathetic compared to what you did.
Get laid? Well, it's just as well I did come in then, isn't it?
Hypocrite.
Look, any of your friends say anything about me?
Nobody recognised you, if that's what you mean. Pity they didn't, really. Teach you to mind your own business.
Oh, you are in a bad mood, aren't you?
Yeah.
Look, I'm only trying to help, honest.
Who needs you?
I'll come back later when you're not feeling quite so sour.
Bloody interfering on. I'll fix her. Hello?
I don't know why I bother. It'd be different if she was my kid, but who is she? I mean, I don't even know her. Oh, God, I must be going soft in the head.
That's the first thing you've said that made any sense.
I just wanted to straighten her out. It's just that she reminds me
of my Debbie. Yes, I know. You've told me and told me. B. Smith, you're a bloody fool. The more you stick your nose into her business, the more you're likely to get into trouble.
Oh, all right, I know.
Well, it's my neck too if you're caught here, and don't you forget it.
How am I going to forget it with you reminding me every second of the day?
Damn, now look what you've made me do.
Hi.
Oh, great, that's just what I need. Haven't you ever heard of knocking?
Are you taking another day off school?
Just thought I'd hang around for a bit, that's all.
What for? Look, Yvonne, you've got to get it through your thick head that we're not the kind of people you should be looking up to.
Speak for yourself.
Shut up. You know what I mean, now, don't you?
Sure.
Look, I know how easy it is to get mixed up in the wrong sort of crowd. You've got to learn to be more choosy.
Jeez, let me get out of here.
Anyhow, I'm not going to tell you what to do anymore. That's between you and your parents. Okay?
Okay.
B, the cops, they're everywhere outside.
God, get out of here.
You'll never make it. What's going to happen to me?
You must have realised that harbouring a criminal is a very serious offence, especially with your record.
But I've been straight for years.
Oh, you stupid cow. Tell them the truth, why don't you? I only got here this morning. I came to ask a friend for a handout, but she wouldn't cough up. Always was a tight-fisted bitch.
When did she arrive, Miss Richardson?
This morning.
We started yelling at each other. I reckon that's when the kid called you lot. Must have heard us.
Well, I told her to get out as soon as she arrived. I didn't want any trouble, I swear.
Where have you been putting up since you broke out of hospital?
None of your damn business. But I've got friends, don't worry. A pity she's not one of them.
Did you notice this woman staying here before this morning? Well?
She just came this morning.
Okay, let's go.
Regular little snitch, aren't you, kid?
We'll get your statements later. And thank you, Miss Haywood.
Thanks. Well, of course, it's pretty much the truth. I didn't want her to stay here, but, well, I had to put her up. You know what Bee's like. She can be pretty tough.
I can always change my story. Just remember that.
It was nice to see some of my old mates from inside. I reckon it's a pity some of you screws don't drop in on them every now and then. They're almost like normal people on the outside. Oh, that's against the rules, isn't it?
Oh, Bee!
Doreen! All right, stop choking me.
Oh, jeez, we missed you. Oh, wait till I tell you what's been happening.
Yeah, I got a few choice bits to tell you, too.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, g'day, Vera. You might be interested in hearing my stories, too. We met a couple of terrific blokes on the outside. Oh, boy, didn't we have a ball.
Will you stop that, Bee, and hurry up?
I was wondering if you'd like to come over for dinner one night.
That'd be nice.
Time, when? Well, tonight, if you like.
Well, I didn't mean to be pushy.
No, I'd enjoy the company.
Listen, now, how's Molly? Oh, God! Steady on, Doc. It's worse than being stabbed in the first place.
It's your own fault, Bee. These stitches should have been taken out days ago. The skin's grown over them.
Yeah, well, it was worth it. Oh! Ow, I think. Yeah, the doc that treated me in the hospital had gentler hands than you.
He's probably too terrified to touch you.
Ow!
Right, that's the lot.
Oh, about bloody time. Oh, God, it doesn't look any better without the stitches. Hey, Mr. Jackson, what do you reckon?
I'm not really interested in your scar, Bee.
No, seriously, as woman to woman, you reckon that's going to spoil the body beautiful?
I think your bikini days are over.
Yeah, well, a bikini's not going to do me much good in here anyhow. Yeah, it's not that I'm glad to be back or anything. I must say, it's going to be nice not to have to sleep with one eye open all the time. Ta.
Oh, God damn, you were back!
Had to pay my respects to a few people first.
What did I tell you? Doesn't she look great?
I've been living it up, have you? Oh, have I got some stories to tell you. Talk about nights of a thousand joys.
Good to see you back, Bee.
Right. How's it going, Moni? Hello, Bee. You've put on weight, you great clodhopper.
Yeah, well, you're not doing too bad yourself.
Didn't Dr. Miller tell you to rest?
I don't need no more.
Right. Back to work, please, everybody.
Yeah, I've only gone a few days and the place has fallen apart. Thought you had in your money.
Yeah, well, things were going okay till she started spreading her wings.
Someone ought to shut that big trap of yours for good, Ferguson.
Nolan and I know each other real well, don't we? Never was the type to stand up to anyone face to face. Always sneaking around behind other people's backs. Just like a rat in a sewer.
You haven't got what it takes, Burke.
You were just standing in for me, Monty.
Maybe you were gone too long. You could do me a bit of a favour.
No way. Oh, look, can't you leave me alone?
She's not doing anything for you, Monty. And nothing's going to happen to stop the work release.
What do you care? It doesn't affect you.
You know your problem. You use your brawn instead of your brain. That's why you haven't been doing so good.
B, when did you get back?
Hello, Prof. How's it going?
Fine, thanks.
Who's for a game of poker? One cigarette for openers.
I haven't got any.
Okay, highest card deals.
There you go.
Oh, would you know? Lizzie's deal. And don't cheat.
Oh, I wouldn't cheat.
Oh, pull the other one.
Third, you dealt me from the bottom of the pack.
Are you calling me a cheat?
Too bloody right.
Come on, do you want to play or not?
Oh, you can stick it, the lot of you.
Oh, God, I don't think I'll get any study in here. You all right? Nolene?
Leave me alone.
Just wanted to know if you were feeling better.
They murdered me, brother.
What?
Pig shot him. Didn't give him a chance.
I'm sorry.
I don't need you to feel sorry for me.
That bloody Lizzie, she's gone. Oh, and what are you doing in here?
It's my room.
You get off my bed. Of all the women inside, I have to end up with a gutter rat. What do I do with those flaming cigarettes? And you, keep out of my way, you hear?
You know what you can do, Smith.
Oh, you two can't be quiet, will you? Go somewhere else.
Oh, sorry, I forgot. Prof wants to study. Can't argue with higher education.
It's a whole lot of bull.
Yeah, look who's talking. You couldn't think your way out of a paper bag.
Shut up!
You gonna sit there all day, Travers? Smith, Burke, on your feet. Mrs. Jackson.
Wake up, Burke.
Good heavens.
No doubt this is some of your handiwork. What did it take both of you?
Must have fallen out of bed, Vera.
Will you women get out of here? What happened, Travers?
You must have slept through it, Miss Bennet.
Well, I think the governor will be very interested in this. Will you be okay to get her to the doctor?
Yes, yes, I can manage.
You've been in here less than a day, and already you're causing trouble.
I woke up with a fist in my face. It was self-defense. Well, doesn't that count?
I'm well aware that during your absence, certain of the women have been vying for your position. Is that still going on?
Don't worry, Mr. Davison. That's all been sorted out. No sweat.
I've got things under control.
The governor and the officers run this prison, not you or any of the other inmates, Smith.
Whatever you say, Vera.
I will not tolerate that sort of insolence. Did you have a hand in this, Travers?
No.
Because it would be a simple enough matter to cancel your study release.
Oh, now, fair go, Mrs. Davis. She didn't have anything to do with it. This is between me and Burke, and it's finished.
It had better be. Now, go and see Dr. Miller. You may go.
You don't trust Smith, do you?
Perhaps if we move some of the women around.
Well, Nolene Burke ought to be locked away on her own.
Yes, I agree. What about Dorian and Izzy?
Troublemakers.
Oh, they're easily led more than anything. Perhaps if we moved in someone who would be of a relatively good influence. Lynn Warner?
Oh, she's been in a single cell long enough.
Yes.
She reckons we've got to stay out of it.
Well, how do we do that?
By sticking together. Well, they can't bash us all up together, can they? Spread the word.
Thought you'd be in the pan.
Nah, sorry to spoil your day. Doc just fixed me up. Thanks for keeping this warm for me.
Shove off, Monty. What if I don't? You gotta wait for some dark night to bash me up like you did Burke?
That's not my style and you know it. You got nothing to worry about as long as you remember I'm back.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking.
That must have been a strain.
Things went pretty well when you weren't here.
Not the way I heard it. Getting rich quick, wasn't it? Making a killing out of Lizzie's first lot of booze. I reckon you ought to split your take with Lizzie.
Yeah, that's what I reckon too.
Oh, shut up, Lizzie.
All right, maybe we ought to let everybody make up their own minds. Okay? Who's it gonna be? I looked after you all right, didn't I?
Looks like they've already decided. Get her out of my road, will you, girls? Doreen, Lizzie?
We don't want any trouble, B.
Looks like you're on your own, Smith.
Doesn't worry me a bit.
Ferguson!
Oh!
Oh! You great place!
Is she okay, Doc? Here, put this under her head.
Unroll it, will you?
Oh. How is she?
Still unconscious.
How did it happen?
It was an accident.
Accident?
Well, she... Mrs. Jackson got in the road.
You will both come with me. The rest of you get to the recreation room. Can I do anything?
Meg. Meg. Meg.
Mrs. Jackson has been hurt because you two stupid women can't act like decent human beings. Well, this time, no more warnings. I shall be putting this in my report to the parole board.
But I'm due out in a couple of weeks.
Not with this in your report. You'll be serving your full term. There's nothing much I can do to punish you, is there, Smith? However, I shall be bringing this before the VJ. No doubt you'll find yourself in solitary for some considerable time. Now get back into the laundry and clean up that mess.
She'll be all right, won't she, Doc?
Luckily, yes.
I'll see you two later.
How did we ever end up like this, B?
Because you were to play Napoleon.
Yeah. Wish thought I could handle authority, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Mind you, if I had a fear...
Oh, shut up!
All right. I'll see you two and raise you two.
I'm out.
Ah. Hey, Doreen. Can't be much fun playing with two.
We don't mind.
Guess what? I've been moved in with you.
Yeah, we know. There's been a big shake-up since Mrs. Jackson got hurt.
Have you heard if she's all right?
No. Mm. You want a game, Linny? We need a third.
Oh, but I've never played.
I will soon teach you.
Next time, stay away from women like Birdsworth, unless you like being used.
Well, I'm sure that Lizzie wouldn't do anything out of malice, Miss Bennet.
Have you heard if Miss Jackson's okay, Miss Bennet?
Better ask your friends, Warner.
Oh, come on, Miss Bennet, we had nothing to do with it.
You're as bad as the ones directly responsible, Anderson. Smith, Ferguson, I've got a few jobs lined up for you two.
Bitch.
At least you could have told us about Mrs. Jackson.
Would you like to have a game of poker, Clara?
Well, I'll have a try.
You'd never dream those rings were paste, would you, Clara?
You can deal the cards, Clara.
Get them back in.
What have you been doing?
Scrubbing out the showers. Oh! Little job Vera thought up for me. Still, at least I did better than Monty. She copped the loos.
Couldn't you and Monty have settled this some other way?
Oh, no, there are some people you just can't talk to. She's so used to bashing her husband, it's all she knows.
B?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think anyone ever starts a new life once they get out of here?
I'd be the wrong person to ask that.
Guess no one ever lets you forget it either.
So I reckon that also depends on you. I mean, if you're going to walk around feeling guilty all the time, people are going to think you are. Mum seems to be doing all right. Now, I better not let this get around or else, but I spent a few days with Mum when I was on the outside.
Bea, you
I know I could have got her into strife. That's not what I wanted to say. She's got herself pretty well set up. And if she can do that after being inside for 12 years, you certainly can.
What's the matter?
Oh, I just wish I could find a bit of me that didn't ache. Oh, that bitch Noel, Lena, has caught me in all my vital parts.
After what you did to her, she's probably feeling pretty much the same.
Yeah. You know, just thinking about that makes me feel better.
Well, I hate to think what you'll do to her next time.
Oh, I don't need for a next time. After all, she's the one that landed in hospital. No point in either of us getting any more trouble. Besides, I'll be releasing Noeline soon and we'll be rid of her.
True.
Tell you what, I envy you getting out every day. How's it going?
Oh, terrific. Can't believe it, though. I keep thinking somebody's going to tap me on the shoulder and call me back, tell me it's all a mistake.
Yeah, I know just what you mean. I felt the same way myself when I was out.
Yeah. Was it really worth it, Bea?
You must be joking. Of course it was. I knew it wasn't going to last long, so I decided to have a ball. And I did. Pity it didn't last a bit longer, though. Tell you what, Brian was a bit of all right. Well, you can laugh. I'll be lucky if I can remember what it's like to be with a bloke by the time I get out.
Thought you'd be in the laundry.
I thought you'd be out in the town.
Oh, privilege is cancelled.
Oh, tough. Nice day for it too. Hey, tell me, what do you do when you get out there?
Oh, go to my lectures, go to the library, sit on the grass, eat my lunch.
Oh, you're a regular little tearaway, aren't you? Don't you ever nick off and have some fun?
I have fun. Just breathing the air outside's fun.
Yeah, but what about the blokes?
What blokes?
Well, the place must be thick with blokes.
Hmm.
Talk, talk, talk. I can hardly get a word in edgewise.
Oh, Bea, I've got to study. If you want company, go to the laundry.
Oh, with that goddard dame big noting herself all over the place, I'd puke in the dryer.
What's Clara ever done to you?
Oh, they think she's Christmas or that stupid.
Just you wait. She'll come the proverbial, you'll see.
But what's she done?
She got us into strife, didn't she?
Oh, you don't think she smashed the television?
All I'm saying is it wouldn't have happened if I'd been in charge. Madam Clara. Couldn't run a sewing bee.
Well, do you know who did it?
I've got a pretty good idea. I'm not stupid. And I know everything that goes on in here. Now, take that doctor boyfriend of yours, for instance. Oh. Not interested?
But he's not my boyfriend.
Oh, then it's no skin off your nose, then, is it?
It's no skin off my nose.
That he's having it off with one of the screws.
I'd say my nose was unaffected. Which one?
Oh, no, you didn't want to know.
Oh. On your feet. I want you two out of here. Smith, you go to the laundry. Travis, you can study in the recreation room.
Hmm. Hey, you all right now, Mrs. Jackson?
Thank you.
That was a nasty bump on the head she got, you know. I'm glad the doctor's looking after you all right.
Not only no colour TV, now we've got no TV at all. And it's not as though we've done it either.
It's iniquitous. I mean, why should you all be punished because of one foolish girl? It's so unfair.
You tell them, Tinkerbell.
You know, you'd think that she'd have the common sense to confess.
Oh, yes, she'd be dead certain to do that.
Well, don't you think so?
Who, me? Are you talking to me?
I thought you said something.
She's like a girl guiding a brothel. She hasn't got a clue.
Well, you don't need a clue if you've got an education.
I've never claimed that education could take the place of practical experience. B, you know this prison inside out. Why don't you find who's responsible?
Why should I?
Well, why not? I mean, we're all being punished for something we didn't do.
But you're the big cheese around here. Now, why don't you do it? And while you're at it, you can have a word with the governor and straighten her out as well.
Very well, I will. Erica is going about this the wrong way.
Isn't she marvellous? Bloody marvellous. All right, garden party over.
Yeah, we had to come inside because of the paddy wagon.
Yeah, they wouldn't trust us to stay out there while the gates were open.
It's petty. How can they expect cooperation when they treat you like that?
And they didn't used to, but they got a down on all of us now.
Dava never used to be that bad. Mind you, she wasn't that good either. But she wasn't Jacobus the way she is now.
Yeah, she's been awful since the barbecue.
Well, you can't really blame her. I mean, she looked like a mug in front of the press and ended up with eagle over her face over that halfway house rubbish.
Yeah, you'd have to be bonkers to think that'd work.
Yeah, and now I miss out on my job and Karen can't go to uni.
Yes, but how was I to know that someone was going to smash the television set? How did you expect me to know?
We didn't expect you to know anything, Tinkerbell.
Kid in the school.
Oh, Irene.
Who's your mate?
Irene Zervos. This is Lizzie.
Hello, love.
And this is Monica.
Monica.
That's right.
What's wrong with her?
There's nothing wrong with her. She's Greek.
Dago, eh?
Dago. Oh,
shut up. Don't talk to me about Greeks. They nearly put me out of business down the beachfront. They have the shop on the corner. Everybody worked in it. Kids, aunties, uncles, grandmother, whole bloody lot of them.
What's wrong with that?
Unfair competition, that's what it was. As long as they could make a cent, they stayed open.
I bet you stayed open when you felt like it.
I kept proper trading hours. And what's more, I kept my place clean. Not like those bloody Dagos.
Be quiet, Ferguson.
Lynn told me you know some Greek.
I taught some Greek children once, but I didn't learn much of the language.
Well, I found these in the library. Of course, you don't have to help, but it would look good on your record.
You don't have to bribe me, Mrs. Jackson.
Bloody Dagos. They come here, they don't bother to learn the language, rob you blind and shoot through. Somebody ought to show them.
I won't warn you again, Ferguson. Now, you take her somewhere less noisy.
Come on.
I want a word with you. What are you up to?
I'm not doing anything.
Exactly. You're not doing anything.
I'm keeping my nose clean. Now, what's wrong with that?
You used to have a lot of influence around here.
Oh, yeah?
I would have thought with you back and Nolene gone, things would get back to normal.
I don't run the jail, Mrs. Jackson. That's your job.
And there was a time you could have made it a lot easier. But it looks like Ferguson's the one in control.
Oh, me old mate money.
That Greek girl, she's a long way from home.
Yeah, well, we all are one way or another, aren't we?
Mm-hmm. So that's the way it is.
Listen, if you want to employ a bit of muscle, why don't you ask Lady Muck?
Who?
Madame Clara. Yeah, that's what you should do. Get with the strength like everyone else.
I see. Your nose is out of joint, isn't it?
Is it? Maybe the doc can fix it.
And maybe he couldn't.
Why not? Fixed you up, didn't he?
Don't be insolent.
Now, what have I said?
Want to have a game?
Oh, don't call me Wong. Sorry.
Ah, call her stupid.
Wong's not stupid.
Oh, sorry, it just slipped out.
Look, anybody who'd have a second go at coming back here has got to be stupid.
Well, you came back more than once.
Say that again, Doreen.
Oh, take it easy, Monty.
Oh, look, just shut up and deal. You'd have the Greek playing with us next, wouldn't you?
Well, you don't have to talk proper to play poker.
No, that's true. You only have to be able to count.
Oh,
they can all do that, even if they can't speak the language.
Don't be so hard on her, Monty. She's only a kid.
I can talk to a pro any way I like.
And how do you know she's on the game?
Oh, look, just shut up and play cards.
You're very quiet, Bea.
Me? I'm semi-retired.
Are you going to let them keep putting her down like that?
You can be tired of being the fastest gun in town.
Oh, no.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson, when are we going to get our deli back?
Which one? The one you used to have or the new one you smashed up?
Oh, I wish I could lay my hands on the one.
Come on, everybody, back to your rooms.
Oh, look at the time. They don't even put kids to bed at this hour.
Get a move on.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson's in a hurry to get home tonight, eh? Bet you got a nice warm bed waiting for you. A nice warm bed and a nice warm doctor.
Hurry up, Ferguson. I've got better things to do than stay here all night.
Same, especially the little kids. If you give them a good example in life, they'll turn out fun.
It's great out there. There's more scenes.
I go here?
Yes, you sleep.
You go here?
No, I go there.
Does door?
Till the morning.
Get out of me way, you wog.
Don't be so bloody rude.
Now you stop that, Ferguson, and hurry up.
Mrs. Jackson, wouldn't she be better off with Bea and me?
I'll think about it. Now get back to yourself.
Good night.
Yeah, well, I don't mind. But as long as she doesn't snore or talk in her sleep, geez. Can you imagine sharing a cell with someone spouting Greek all night?
You might learn the language. Hey, that's an idea, Bea. Why don't you take up Greek?
What in the hell for?
So you can get yourself a Greek boyfriend when you get up.
When I get out of here, I'll be past it. I'll have no teeth, my hair will be grey and... Shut up about when I get out of here.
Monica started in on Irene. It's the law of the jungle, isn't it? Pick off the weakest first.
Yeah. Well, if you're going to be a weakie, you've got to learn to expect that.
Oh, Bea, you don't mean that. What's wrong with you, Bea? You were always in their boots and all when anyone was having a hard time.
Look, I told you, I've retired. I am minding my own business, and it's a shame you don't do the same.
You're sulking. That's it, isn't it?
I've taken enough from you. Now shut up!
Oh, Bea! Look, it's Clara Goddard, isn't it? She comes in here, fixes things up, cheers people up, and you can't stand
it. I'm warning you!
Oh, come on, Bea, you're a reasonable woman. What's the matter with you? Can't you see how stupid this is?
Look, Miss University student, what makes you think you can get inside my head? I know what I'm doing. I was Queen Bea around here for years, and I'll be Queen Bea again. I have no intention of giving up that title to a gutless contender like Clara Goddard.
Aha, we haven't retired.
Oh, retired be damned. I'm just giving that little laddie enough rope.
Yeah, and in the meantime, we get no television, we're pushed off to bed at 6:30, work and study release has been cancelled, we're watched 24 hours a day, but Monica slipped a leash.
Yeah, look, it only happened with Tinkerbell in charge. And just how long do you think it's going to take before they wake up to her?
Got you bluffed, hasn't she? She's got everybody thinking she's kingpin.
Oh, let her.
Let the brainless tarts follow her. They'll see it my way when I'm ready.
I wouldn't hang by me thumbs, Lo. Oh, hello. Anybody here smell olive oil? Oh, nothing personal, love. I just must be feeling a bit off. Must be coming down with a wob.
If you weren't so contemptible, you'd be totally pathetic. How would you like it if you were faced with the possibility of being deported?
Ah, good riddance.
You don't understand. Irene came out here to get married. Now it looks as if she's going to be sent back.
Serve her right. If she's stupid enough to go on the game and get caught, she's got to take what's coming to her. Why'd the stupid cow do it anyway?
I don't know. I haven't been able to get through to her well enough to find out.
Look, if you do, just tell her to keep out of my way. I've had enough of her kind outside.
Clara, you're supposed to have some control.
I hope so.
Well, then get Monica off Irene's back, will you?
That's a good idea, Tinkerbell. Why don't you sort Monnie out? Show her who's boss around here.
Oh, boy, can you smell that?
I certainly can.
It's cabbage. I love boiled cabbage.
I think it's revolting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Maybe I just got used to it. Or maybe I got a tapeworm. Yeah, that could be it. I could have a tapeworm.
Oh, I don't think so, love. Tapeworms are choosy.
Oh, Bea, don't be disgusting.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Goddard. I forgot we don't talk about tapeworms here in track, do we?
Oh, here comes a little grease spot again. Listen, there's none of you minced up goats in vine leaves here, up. None of that dago crap today.
Leave her alone.
You keep out of this. Maybe you'd be more at home in a fish and chip shop. Here, or maybe the Olympia Cafe. That's it, Olympia. You know that word, eh? Olympia, Olympia. Olympia. I don't give me any of that dago crap.
That's quite enough. Come on, everybody. Inside. Come on, move along. Not you, Ferguson. I want a word with you.
What do you want?
I suppose you think you're very smart.
Look, if I was that smart, I wouldn't be.
Play your cards right and you could get out earlier than you expected.
Why?
You've still got 1 month of your sentence to serve. But the parole board meets next week and there's a good chance you'll get a 3 weeks remission.
What's the catch?
Just start treating that Greek girl like a human being and not like an animal.
Oh, look, she doesn't understand a word I'm saying anyway.
All right, if you think it's worth 3 weeks of your time in here to insult her, just keep it up. As I said, the parole board meets next week.
You're not such a bad screw after all.
I'm just suggesting you make it easier on yourself.
Yeah. Well, look, I'm sorry you got hurt the other day. It was an accident.
I'm all right. But you're apologizing to the wrong person.
I thought you were going to stick up for Irene.
Yeah, it's not fair the way Monnie's been treating her.
Yeah, why don't you do something about it, Clara?
Oh, wake up to yourselves. Tinkerbell's gutless, aren't you, love?
Just wasn't the right time.
Yeah, never will be.
What about right now?
Oh, I don't think lunchtime's the appropriate time.
Oh, watch her footwork. Watch her footwork.
You're not frightened of Monnie, are you, Clara?
Oh, of course not. It's just as I said, it's a matter of timing. Very well, then.
Very well what?
I will talk to her.
Oh, this I've got to see.
Go on, Clara.
I have something to say to you.
Yeah?
It's about the way you treat Irene.
Yeah?
I think you're being most unfair to her. She's a stranger in our midst, and she doesn't speak the language. And I think you're being too hard on her.
Oh, you do, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, maybe you're right. Sorry about that, kid. Cabbage, eh? Can't be all that bad.
You were terrific, just terrific.
It's nothing. It's just
just a matter of being reasonable, that's all. Geez, I would never have been that game.
Three jacks.
Hey,
I've got three jacks.
Oh, hell, there goes the sheep station. Hey, Moni. I reckon it was Mrs. Jackson and not Tinkerbell that ticked you off about Irene. What do you say to that?
I'd say mind your own business. I make my own decisions, nobody else.
Oh, yeah, and that flapping sound, I can hear a pig's flying by.
Turn that television off and pay attention. The governor has something to say.
As you may already know, the prison will be under investigation by a visiting justice on behalf of the prison's department. I want to be sure you are all aware you have the right to approach the justice, either with or without legal assistance.
What?
If you have any questions, I am sure Miss Bennett or Mrs. Jackson will be able to answer them. That is all, ladies. Good evening.
Good night.
Maybe I can complain about having my work release cancelled.
Thank you. Well, I'm certainly going to complain about the conditions in this prison.
Do you think we could get rid of Vera?
Looks like you'll be cashing your super in early.
I wouldn't count on it, Smith.
I reckon the girl's got enough complaints to choke a horse.
Including riotous behaviour on your part. No, I think the justice will see things from the viewpoint of authority. In fact, if anyone leaves here because of slack regard for regulations and lack of proper discipline, I can assure you it won't be me.
You really think Clara can do it?
Of course I do. Then after lunch, she's parting the Red Sea and walking on the fish pond. Wake up.
I'm going to miss you if you go out again. I'll have to do the garden on my own.
No worry, Doreen. The governor's not going to listen to Clara. Hey, Moni.
Oh, who knows? Who cares?
Warner, you'll be late.
Late?
You'll miss the bus to work. Get cracking.
You mean it's all right?
I mean you're on day release, and you'll be late for work if you don't get going.
Terrific!
Good on you, Liz.
See you.
Bye.
What C was that, B?
Do you want a thick ear, Doreen? Well, I don't know how she does it.
I didn't think she had a hope in hell either.
Travers, do you have any lectures scheduled for today?
This afternoon, Anthrop 1.
Oh, fine. Then there's not as much of a hurry for you to get away.
You mean it's all right? I can go too.
That's right.
Oh, that's terrific. Well, I'm damned if I know how she did it, but it's all right by me.
Oh, for she's a jolly good fellow, for she's a jolly good fellow.
Thank you, Clara. How'd you do it?
I just reasoned with her. Oh,
thank you. Thank you so much. I have to go. Yasu. Yasu. Bye.
Bye.
Has to be regular. I mean, once a week it do.
Oh, wake up to yourself, Lizzie.
But she's got everything she tried to get so far, hasn't she?
And now you think you can get yourself a regular grog ration.
Well, they get it in the Navy.
They have sailors in the Navy too. Hey, do you reckon she can get one of them in once a week?
But she's always got whatever she wants.
Oh, come on. Next thing you'll be telling me she's getting out of here.
Come to say goodbye.
Goodbye? You mean they're letting you out of here?
That's right, Lizzie. Well, what's so funny?
Nothing. Where are you going?
Fairly. They're transferring me to Fairly.
Well, now, is that right? I know the head shrang over there among the women. She'll give you a run for your money.
I don't think so, B. I'll be in the remand section. It's to keep me away from the hardened criminal element.
Very funny.
How are we going to get along without you here?
Oh, it's... Us B, right?
She's bloody right.
Come on, Goddard. Wagon's out the front.
I just heard...
What are you doing here?
Oh, well, Clara's leaving.
That's none of your business.
But I just come to say goodbye.
You're supposed to be working in the garden. Now get out there.
I just could...
Get out!
Oh. That makes you feel 10 feet tall, Miss Bennett.
Come on, Goddard.
You two, it's hers. Give them a couple of days to realise the Queen Bee's back on top. Just a couple of days.
You're all heart.
Yeah, it's me basic good nature. What are you reading?
Oh, anthropology.
I'm sorry I asked.
Baths.
Eh?
That's what I'm going to complain about. Baths. I reckon we should all have separate cells with little dunnies and baths off them. Get a bit of privacy. There's no dignity in sharing.
Half-wit. What's wrong with sharing?
Frankie used to look at my bum all the time. It's not nice.
You're right, I have seen better.
Well, I think there's a good case for asking that prisoners like Irene, who can't speak English, have an interpreter laid on.
Oh, that bitch! She'll get hers one of these days.
What's wrong, love?
Bloody Vera. Lynn brung me home this pot plant and she ripped it out by the bloody roots. I'll give a contra bloody band. It'll die on me for sure now.
Well, there's one for the VJ.
Oh, yeah. I'm sick of this place. They've all got something coming, I reckon.
What about you, B? You going up in front of the justice?
Yeah, but I'm not going to be doing the complaining. What with that little holiday I took and the mess I had to clean up when I got back here, I reckon they got me over a barrel.
I'd rather we talked alone.
I'm sure anything we have to discuss can be discussed in front of the officer.
Yeah, but this is a private matter? Personal, like. Please.
Wait outside. Now, what is this highly secret personal matter?
Well, it's personal to me as well as you.
I'm waiting.
I want to do a deal with you.
Open the door and ask the officer to come back in, thank you,
yeah,
Smith.
Well, just a minute. Before you go getting the wrong end of the stick, I reckon I can help you.
You? Help me?
Well, it's not so silly. You haven't been down to the rec room lately.
I fail to see what that has to do with anything.
You wouldn't if you'd been there. And what with the VJ coming, I reckon those girls are going to have a million whinges.
They have a right to complain.
Yeah, but you're not going to come out of it looking real good. In fact, listening to them, you're going to come out of it a dead mug. Now, I run those girls. And if I say there aren't going to be any complaints, well, what I say goes.
I admire your hide, if nothing else. What do you expect to get out of this little exercise?
Well, I've got to go up on a charge over that fight with me and Monnie.
Yes.
Well, if you was to do the right thing and chuck in a good word for me.
Number one, what you are suggesting slaps of collusion and is simply untenable. Number two, I am not so uncertain of my position here that I have to depend on your assistance in any matter. It was a nice try, Smith. And it's only because I admire your cheek that you're not up on another charge. Call the officer to take you back.
Yeah. Suit yourself. But, well, the way the girls are at the moment, between them and Vera, I reckon Custer had more chance than you. And the Redskin scalped him.
Smith, a report has gone to the department about the brawl. The justice already knows about it. I can't change that, even if I wanted to.
Right. But, well, I can do 2 days in the hole on my ear. But 10 days and I'll be right round the twist. Know what I mean?
I can't promise you anything.
Well, I wouldn't ask you to do that, Mrs. Davidson.
Doreen?
Well, why'd you do it?
Oh, if you'd have bitched your heads off, you probably would have got the governor the chop.
Whacko the diddle-o!
You thick tart. If Davidson goes, we'll probably end up with Vera's boss cocky.
Oh, geez, I never thought of that.
What are you looking for, you silly old bag?
A cockroach.